Good afternoon. My name is Shinichi Akaike, Director of Foresight Center of National Institute of Science and Technology Policy in Japan. So, it is a great pleasure to speak here, make a presentation here at the second Asian Innovation Forum. So I would like to talk about Foresight and web-based policy making in Japan. So my talk includes first of all, introduction and science of science policy and foresight activity in Japan and conclusion. Japanese current situation. So Japan's total R&D expenditure is slowly increasing, while of China and the United States are rapidly increasing for recent years. But so now the number of doctor students is now stagnant in Japan. So we are very afraid of our research potential. Now, we also have some figures on academic papers. So the charts are based on our analysis of NISTEP. Although the value of scientific papers produced in Japan has remained at the same level in recent years, but Japan has dropped in rank due to increasing volume of papers produced by other countries. So now our position is so under this under the situation, we enacted the fifth science and technology basic plan. So the Japanese government launched Science and Technology Basic Plan in 1996, and now we are under the fifth basic plan. So the fifth basic plan states the first one is target for national budget for science and technology policy. It's 26 trillion yen Japanese yen. And the second one is we proposed the concept of super smart society called Society 5.0. So Society 5.0 is very difficult concept. So it's integration of cyberspace physical space, the real world. It includes the energy value chain and new manufacturing systems. So it's development of the IoT system and others. So we are trying to combine the cyber activities and real activity, manufacturing and so on. The fifth means, the first one, first society is hunting and gathering. So the second one is agriculture, and third is industry, and then fourth, and information society. Then fifth is we call it fifth society 5.0. Next one slide is our government system for R&D. We have the cabinet office. It covers all the government activity. So enacting science and technology based plan and resource allocation, allocation and so on. We have next and other ministries, and then about 800 universities and some research research institutes and funding agencies. So research institutes include RICAN, NIMS and other major research institutes. And we also have JSPS and JST and other funding agencies. So AMLM is newly established funding agency. It is so called Japan's NIH. So it covers basic research for life science and the applied research for medical use. And the second I will talk about the science of science. So evidence-based policy making is significantly important to promote the science, technology, and innovation policy in order to the public's confidence. So we have some philosophies of the science of science and science STI policy. So the first one, formulate policy based on scientific rationality, and second and third one, fourth, fifth. So anyway, so we think it is important to have good relationship with the public. And so we also have enacted action plan. So the science of science policy contribute to various layers of national policies. From national strategy to ministry level measures and funding agencies and research institutes and universities and so on. So we have some think tanks for science STI policy research. So the first one is the oldest one is NISTEP. So I'm belonging to the SILEX Center, quite new one, and CRDS and DAT. So and other public think tanks. What is NISTEP? NISTEP was established in 1988. So it has various activities for policy research, policy studies. So it includes innovation studies, bibliometrics works and foresight activities, and so on. So I will introduce some examples of our studies. So first one is science map science map. So it's a mapping for research areas. So it is based on bibliometrics. So science map is a map of scientific research, and it shows the interrelationships among research areas. The active research state. So the research areas are generated by clustering the top 1% of highly cited papers using post citational analysis. It shows some emerging area of science. And also we have National Innovation Survey, called JNIS, based on a post manual of OECD. And so we also show activities of our innovation. So Japan is good at process innovation rather than product innovation and so on. And we also established doctoral human resource database for J-grant. So it is a follow-up system of carriers or doctoral holders. So it is very important to grasp the situation of human resources for science and technology. Science and technology. So it is for something so gathering alumni information of major top universities. And the second slide shows the SIREX program. It started 2011, and so that is some new system. So it is a sister program of SciSIP in United States. So the program includes some developing human resources for policy research. So collaborate with some top universities in Japan. And we have also established information structure, databases, and research funding and so on. And CRT is a very unique think tank of Japan. So it's the proposals, it makes a policy proposal for national research strategy based on so research data areas. So it is used for funding, new funding system of Japan's JST and other funding agencies. So I'm moving to our Foresight activity. So our Foresight activity has a very long history. It started so 1971 and so we experienced 10 times of Foresight process. So the first stage, so we targeted so advancement of so science and technology itself, but now we think much of relationship so science and technology activity with social situation. So yeah, the 10th one is quite the latest one. So our process consists of two stages. So first stage is to identify the future of social vision, and then second stage, the future perspective on science technology. And we integrate these information and then make scenarios. So scenarios for the future. That is our process. And we so scenario planning from our 10th foresight. Shows about 8 scenarios. So manufacturing, services, ICT, and so on. So I show the example of of transporting system. So we targeted 2030, and so we also use podcasting and so making the foresight. And now, so we are trying to change our foresight system because it is very difficult to forecast the future. And so the describing the future, it is not critical for us. So we are trying to find weak signals and so wild cards of social situations and emerging technology. So some countries try to introduce so horizon scanning process. So for United Kingdom is very famous for the horizon scanning, and so for European Union also introduced the horizon scanning for the strategic planning. We are trying to combine it. So our traditional foresight process with horizon scanning. And this is a little bit complicated process, but so in that process, we would like to find the switch signal and wildcard, and then accumulate them and use for foresight. It is so our just a new process for the foresight. And we also we would like to use foresight process for scanning the wildcard and so new signal of technology and the sort of social situation. So so that is so application for so big data analysis. So we are surveying for example patent, press release, is academic papers and Twitter and so on. So we gather the information and crawling and text analysis and find information and extract and information from that. So it is, but that is just around the process. The information includes many noise. So it is not so as development now. So developing stage, but we are trying to find. So new process using ICT. Anyway, we would like to move to a new stage for our foresight. Okay, the conclusion. So evidence-based policy, evidence-based policy formation through variation policy is required. So. Making use of evidence as shared social resources which serves as a foundation for public participation in policy formation. Develop science and technology to realize evidence-based policy formation. And shifting foresight methodology to share visions for future with the public. Strengthen our collaboration with Asian countries in foresight and evidence-based policy making. Thank you very much. Thank you for your attention.